So low power VLSI design, low power design. So why it is a very important in the VLSI circuits, we'll discuss now. Low power, historical figure of merit for VLSI design performance, that is nothing but circuit speed and chip area. These are the major factors. So what is the area required for the designing of the IC, and what is the speed of the IC? Okay, these two parameters are dependent on the power dissipation. The power dissipation is now an important metric in VLSI design. Power dissipation, how much power it is taking or absorbing. Power dissipation is now an important metric in VLSI design. No single major source for power savings across all design levels. Okay, by using a single source or by using a single element, we can't able to save the power. Okay, no single major source for savings across all design levels. Reduced a new way of thinking. Okay, so our power is distributed into different elements. We have a number of ICs or number of circuits. For power supply circuit, we need some energy. And for other circuits, we need some energy. Like that, we are distributing the power. So where we will reduce the power? We don't know. So no single major source for power savings across all design levels. Where we will save the power, initial stage, we don't know. So now the thinking came. How to reduce the power? The companies lack the basic power, power conscious culture, and designers need to be educated in this respect. Overall goal to reduce the power dissipations but maintaining adequate throughput rate. Okay, otherwise maintaining the adequate outputs. So our main goal is to reduce the power dissipation in the VLSI circuits without disturbing the exact outputs. Okay, if you are reducing the power, output is somewhat reducing in this way, we can't able to say. Without changing the output, by maintaining the adequate outputs, how to reduce the power? That is our goal. Need for low power VLSI chips. What is the need of low power VLSI chips? Okay, what is the low power? Why we have to reduce the power consumption? Why we have to operate our devices with low power? That is the major issue. So power dissipation was neglected due to low device density, low operating frequency. This was neglected, power dissipation was neglected due to low device density, low operating frequency. Okay, and now it is important issue due to high device density, high operating frequency. So previously, if we have more power dissipation, no problem. So device density is low, operating frequency is low, power dissipation also low, no problem. Now, we have to increase the density of the circuit. So high device density we need. And we have to operate with high frequency. We have to use high frequency ranges. That is why we have to focus on low power or power. So competitive reasons, low power. So battery powered systems. So extended battery life and reduce weight and size. If you reduce the power, so external battery life will increase and weight and size also reduce. Okay. For example, 10 volt supply we need. And now that is reduced to 9 volts battery. Okay. If it is, for example, lead battery. So the size is more. If you use a 9 volts battery, and the size is very less. Okay, size will reduce and weight also will reduce, size and weight will reduce when we operating with low power, and the battery life will also increase. Then high performance systems, the cost and package, that is a chip, carrier, heat sink, card slots, and so on. That is a package. And power system, supplies, distribution, regulators, this is the power systems. These are high performance systems, package, power systems, and fans, noise, power reliability, area, and operating cost to customer, energy star issue. Okay, so next is reliability. Failure rate increased by 4 into the temperature. Size and weight. What are those? These are all competitive reasons of low power. So why we have to reduce the power is nothing but for the high performance and to improve the battery life and reduce the weight and size of the battery. These are some issues, some reasons. So to reduce the cost for reliability and to reduce the size and the weight, we are going to reduce the power. We are going to operate with the low power. So of course, this is known to you, Moore's Law, 1965, Gordon Moore noted that the number of transistors on a chip doubled every 18 to 24 months. This is known to you. He made a prediction that semiconductor technology will double its effectiveness every 18 months. This is the rate of change of transistors from every 18 months. Okay, so evolution, complexity, they are not required, transistor count. Okay, so we are going to increase the transistor count. Why we are discussing this Moore's Law is nothing but, if you are increasing the transistor count, we will increase the power. Power improvement also increases. So how to reduce that power when we increase the more number of transistors? That is why we are going to discuss about low power VLSI. So this is some basic. Not only in the microprocessors and controllers, but also in the maximum all devices, we are going to operate with a low power. What is the problem if we have high power, if you are operating with a high power? Why worry about power? Portable devices can't able to manufacture with high power. So handhelds, laptops, phones, MP3 players, cameras all need to run for extended periods on small batteries without recharging. Okay, these are all operating with a low power, maybe 5 volts. Okay, 5 volts. So for portability, we have to reduce the power. If you are using rechargeable batteries, then the size is more. You can't able to carry sometimes. Okay. So next, devices that need regular recharging or large heavy batteries will lose out to those that don't. Okay. If you use those type of batteries, size will be high, heavy batteries. So their reliability will decrease. If you use high power devices, if you want to use high power, then can't able to carry these laptops, phones, MP3 players, and so on, cameras. Now, all those are operating with the low power. That is why we are going to carry phone and laptop and MP3 players and cameras without any help. If you are without reducing the power, if you use those devices, we have to carry some big bag. in that bag we have to keep power supply, and in the same manner in another bag we have to keep your MP3 player, phones, laptops. We need someone's help, one assistant we need. If you are operating with the same high power without reducing the power, so that is the need of power. With all the other operating with the low power, that is why we are going to we can able to carry those devices. Okay, next is a power consumption important even in the third devices, that is a system cost, tracks power consumes, power supplies, distribution, and heat removal. There also we are using low power devices. Okay, this is complete introduction. These are some basics, power supply basics, power basics. Okay, this is complete introduction regarding how to measure and compare power consumption. One popular metric for microprocessor is MIPS for watt. The same problem with MIPS for watt. Metrics then power in CMOS. This is a major factor. Basically, if you are initially we are operating with 5 volts. Initially, we are operating CMOS with 5 volts. Now that can be converted into 3.5 volts. 3.5 volts. And power is decreasing. Power is decreasing with additional techniques. Additional techniques. If you observe the FPGAs from one version to another version, J-Links to Spartan, we are going to reduce the operating power, applied voltage here. That is reduced to 3.5 volts. Okay. Then switching power with the explanation, with the some expressions he has given. Of course, we'll go to our syllabus, no problem. Scaling switching energy per gate. Again, I'm saying that scaling means shrinking the transistor size. We're going to reduce the transistors. That is a scaling and shrinking. Then if your size is reduced, automatically power consumption also reduces. That is why we need a scaling. That is why in the syllabus he is explaining about scaling of the voltages. So here speed and power are the major factors. We need more speed, less power. Less power, this is a challenge for the device engineers. Okay, you can increase the speed, reduce power. Three strategies for low power. So multiple VTH, variable VTH, multiple VDD, variable VDD. So active and standby. So threshold voltage variations. By controlling the applied voltage and threshold voltage, you can able to get the low power. Low power, one way that is. If you're using high power, more temperature will generate, more heat will generate. And high performance microprocessor generates 50 watts power. And packaging cost and cooling cost. Packaging cost and cooling cost. If more heat will be generated, cooling cost will increase. Increase. Okay, then these are some points related to low power. threshold voltage also one of the point, threshold voltage and VDD. So what is the initial transistor's power and what is the advanced transistor's power now? If you are using advanced technologies, what is the power? Okay, all those we'll see. Some more factors. This is our chapter, low power VLSI circuits, CMOS logic circuits. In the introduction, what he has given, the increasing the increasing prominence of portable systems and the need to limit power consumption in very high density VLSI chips have led to rapid and innovative developments in low power design during the recent years. Okay, for the portable systems, I already told you, for the portable systems, if you want to if you can able to carry any system, there is a portable system. Those portable systems can be maintained with a low power. Low power. So of course, in ULSI coming technology, in ultra large scale integration chips have led to rapid and innovative developments in low power. Now we are using very low power devices. In coming technology, still the power can be reduced. Still the power can be reduced. That is the coming technology. The driving forces behind these developments are portable device applications. Again, same point. Portable device applications. Why we are going to use a low power? So that is nothing but to carry in the portable device applications. Low power dissipation and a high throughput, such as a notebook, computers, portable communication devices, and personal digital assistants (PDAs). In all those, we need low power. In most of the cases, the requirements for low power consumption must be met along with equally demanding goals of high chip density and high throughput. Hence, low power design of digital integrated circuits has emerged as a very active and rapidly developing fields. Low power design in digital integrated circuits has emerging technology, very active, and those are demanding sectors. That is a major factor. How to reduce the power is the major thing. Okay, then the limited battery lifetime typically imposes very strict demands on the overall power consumption of the portable system. If the lifetime of my laptop or my mobile or my any device, a camera, is less, I can't able to prefer that one. Stick to demands that is not having any demand. So whatever the portable devices we are using, those lifetimes must be high. That can be possible with low power design, low power consumption. Okay, so that is the main aspect. So the limited battery lifetime typically imposes very strict demands on the overall power consumption of the portable system. Okay, although new rechargeable battery types such as nickel metal hydride NIMH batteries are being developed with a higher energy capacity than that of the conventional nickel cadmium batteries. Revolutionary increase of the energy capacity is not expected in the near future. Already we have nickel cadmium batteries. Those are some starting batteries. Now we have advanced batteries. Those are rechargeable with a nickel metal hydride batteries. That is a somewhat revolutionary increase of the energy capacity. That is also not enough in the future. In the future, then the energy density. Density means amount of energy stored for unit weight. That is the density. Energy density is nothing but amount of energy stored for unit weight. Amount of energy stored for unit weight is nothing but energy density. The energy density offered by the new battery technologies is about 30 Webers for, I will say this one, battery, watts per area, watts per area maybe. So which is still low in view of expanding applications of the portable systems. In portable systems, we are using very vast applications, okay, very advanced applications we are using in portable systems. So this frequency, this power, battery power is not enough. That is why we are going to use other techniques. Therefore, reducing the power dissipation in integrated circuits through design improvement is major challenge in portable system design. This is completely description regarding why low power. Why low power? This is okay. Not only there, next ULSI also. Next in the digital signal process applications, microprocess applications, all those we need low power with high performance. So how we can achieve that? How we can achieve that is nothing but introduction to low power. The methodologies which are used to achieve low power consumption in digital systems span a wide range from device by from process level to algorithm level, process level algorithm level. And the device characteristics, threshold voltage, device geometrics, and interconnect properties are significant factors in lowering the power consumption. If you want to reduce the power consumption, what are the interconnections? What is the geometry? And the same manner, device characteristics, that is the threshold voltage. All this we have to consider. These are some parameters to reduce the power consumption. By taking these parameters, we are going to reduce the power. The same in the clock circuits also. Clocking circuits strategies can be used to reduce the power dissipation. Why? How we can reduce the power is nothing but by checking the clock strategies and interconnections, and in the same manner, threshold voltages, device geometries, all those. By considering all those factors, we can be able to reduce the power. Architecture level measures include smart power management of various system blocks. We have different blocks, all those blocks included in the low power to reduce the power. Overview of power consumption. So this overview of the power consumption we'll see in the next class, because this is a fifth hour. Fifth hour MPMC. Fifth hour is MPMC.
Yes, sir.
How to reduce the power, we'll see later. Okay. So with some brief discussion, I will go through that one and I will explain in easy way. Okay. Thank you all. This is one of the introduction for low power VLSI.